Hi everybody, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we are going to see a general love spread for whoever this resonates with. So I'm doing a general love reading for anybody who's watching, and take the message that resonates with you and leave the rest. If it resonates, let me know how it resonated in the comments. If you want to have a personal reading, link is in the description. If you want to follow my Instagram, the link is again in the description. Now let's see the message. Give me the present energy for my few viewers in love. What is happening in my viewers' love life? Give me present energy. So we have the Ten of Pentacles here. So some of you might be dealing with an earth sign. For others of you, I just feel that these days you're very focused on money, business, your career. So you're trying to be more resourceful. You're trying to be more stable in your personal life. All right, some of you, family and home environment is center of attention of your life these days. So you're investing a lot of time with your family, with home, being with friends, just trying to be around people who you care about and people who care about you. So that's happening, right? And when it comes to love as well, you're trying to see someone who can actually be a part of your family. So you are someone who's a very family oriented person, and you're trying to find a suitable person who can become a part of your family and who you can actually introduce to your family. You're basically looking for a commitment or marriage, okay? You're not up for flings. You're trying to see if commitment can happen. Okay, what else? What's the blockage in love life of my viewers? Six of Swords. The blockage here is that though you're trying to just move forward and you're trying to see all the good in a situation, but there is like a past situation of yours which still keeps you stuck. So maybe there is something from the past which is on your mind and it still bothers you. For most part, I see you're trying to move forward and you're trying to do good in your life, and you're almost successful in it as well with the Ten of Pentacles. So I see that you are doing a good job at it, but then still there's like a past person or a past situation which still clogs your mind a lot. And so, you know, like, it's like you're putting in the work in your life, but then every time you get reminded about that situation, something kind of hinders you, and then you don't want to put in the hard work in the situation. So that can happen. So it's like 1 foot forward, 2 foot backwards, that kind of a situation happening, in which is kind of slowing the process for you. Some of you, you're still not able to process the trauma that your last relationship gave you. So every time you want to walk forward, you just get reminded of it and then you come back. So just work on that, all right? Don't try to become a blockage in your own life. What is the incoming influence in love for my viewers? Death card. See, again, I see a situation is going to come to an end, and that situation is actually this situation that is blocking you. Some of you, I see that a major transformation is going to happen in your life, right? Which is going to lead you to unblocking yourself and moving forward. So something that has not come to an end, like the situation might have ended, but it has not gone away from your energy. Like, you still cling on to a past situation very tightly. It was toxic as hell. Some of you, this person actually they've thrown you out of the home, or they just left you out in the cold, or they did not care about you. Something about a person who was like toxic as fuck. But, and you know that this person is toxic as fuck, and you're trying to move on, and you have moved on to a quite extent, but then, you know, that trauma kind of haunts you still. I see that trauma is going to go, and that cycle is basically going to come to an end completely, and you will be transforming through that situation so that you can accept these blessings in your life, all right? So yeah, be ready for some transformation in life. So what is the conscious goal of my viewers in their love life? Five of Swords, exactly. See, so more than finding a new person, your conscious goal when it comes to love life is that you need to get rid of your traumas, all right? So I don't see that you're actively pursuing love these days with the Ten of Pentacles. Also, we saw that you are hoping for a commitment, but you're not actively pursuing it. Your focus is actually on your building your stability, being with your family, spending family time and all of that. You're just trying to get rid of a trauma, all right? That's what I see. With the Five of Swords being your conscious goal again, I feel that there has been a situation which has deeply, deeply disturbed you, and all that you want right now is to overcome that fear, that trauma, so that you can actually welcome love in your life again, and you can be more trusting of love. Because of the past situation, now you've become very untrust full. Like, you're like, I can't trust people, or I can't open up to people. Everybody's a jerk. So that's what you feel, but you just want to get rid of that. So what is the unconscious influence in my readers, in my viewers' love life? I'm the reader. In my viewers' love life, what's the unconscious influence? The Emperor. There is someone who's coming towards you. This person could be elder to you. Someone who's very stable. They are some sort of an authority in their personal life, professional life, I mean. This person also has their shit together. So very stable person, very mature person is actually making their way into your life. And that's exactly what you want, right? With the Ten of Pentacles, we saw that you are looking for stability. You are not looking for a relationship. You're looking for a commitment. You don't want to like just have coffee dates or movie dates with somebody. You're looking for someone who you can actually bring home, introduce to family, or maybe just tie knot or just be together like long term. That's what you're hoping for, and that's exactly what's coming towards you. So yeah, I see a very stable person coming into your life. But all of this is actually going to happen when you will be able to undergo this transformation. And you will be going through a transformation very soon, I feel, or you are already going through a transformation, because in order to release a trauma, you need to undergo a transformation, right? So let us see, how is this person going to view my viewer when they come into their life? Page of Sword. Some of you really need to work on your insecurities, because I see even an Empress kind of a person is going to step into your life, but how they see you will be someone who is a Page of Sword. So your insecurities will be very clearly visible to this person, all right? And before that happens, just work on yourself. I see someone is going to see you as someone who's very clever. I won't say cunning, but I would say very intelligent, and somebody who can take advantage of the other people. You don't want to come out as someone who take advantage of other people. So be very careful that you do not project your insecurities on this person so that they think that you are malicious, right? So just be very careful. And I definitely feel you are going to be the younger one here, because see how they view you as is Page of Sword, and how they are is the Emperor, alright? So just be careful of that. I see somebody is going to see you as someone who's like very panicky at times, and that's all happening because you've gone through a trauma. So just fix yourself before you fuck up the situation, you fuck up the blessing. Just fix yourself, my viewers. This is your advice in the reading, alright? And let's see, how is the viewer going to watch this person as? Like, what are your feelings towards this person? Three of Wands. You would definitely want to take a leap of faith towards them, and you would want this connection to progress. So I see, like, there is somebody who's coming towards you in your life, your love life, which is full of potential. This person is mature than you. They have their shit together, and this person definitely has potential, and you would want to explore that potential and take the next step in the connection. I see that in 3 weeks from now, you will be planning your next move in the connection. You would want to take things to the next level, and some planning and all of that is going to happen. But just be careful that this person might actually find you as someone who's scared, very closed off, panicky, you know, having some trauma or all of that. So just fix yourself. That's just a message here, very significant. So what is the hope and fear of my viewer in this love situation? Seven of Swords. See, again, like, that just keeps coming. You guys are paranoid. You are very scared of getting cheated again. Some of you, you know, again, as I said, more than finding love in your life, you are more scared of not getting, you're more scared of getting cheated. See, again, the Seven of Swords, that's your fear. You don't want to get cheated. And some of you, the problem with you is that before somebody can actually cheat you, you kind of build the whole scenario in your mind and you ghost people, or you just try to run away from love situations. Before somebody can actually approach you and the connection can go forward, you just run away from the situation because you are too scared to get your heart broken. Come out of your fear. You don't have to build unnecessary scenarios in your mind, right? If you've gone through something, identify that and heal, instead of repeating the same pattern over and over again, and instead of being so paranoid. Not everybody is same. What's going to be the outcome here for my viewers in their love life? Six of Cups. Ooh, some of you, this person who's coming towards you is someone you have already known. So this could be like a friend, high school sweetheart, ex-colleague, or somehow maybe you know this person. I see a very beautiful union possible for you 6 months down the line. I see somebody and you are going to be like happily committed and all of that. Some of you, you're going to meet this person through your friends. If it's not directly friend, then you will meet them through friend. But the only thing that makes me cautious here is this page of sword and seven of sword. You need to fix your issues before you meet this person. Otherwise, the commitment is going to be difficult. Because I see this person loves you. There's like a lot of potential. There's definitely scope for growth here. But because of your own insecurities, you might just fuck this up. And so if you don't fuck this up, you need to undergo this transformation. Identify your own toxic patterns. Understand your own patterns in life and fix them. Try to find healing. Some of you, you need to take some coaching or do some inner work before you can get yourself in a relationship. Do the inner work so that you don't repeat a pattern again, all right? The problem with people these days is that they get out of a toxic relationship and then they get into another relationship before they can actually sit down with themselves and analyze what went right, what went wrong, and where they could change things and how they can change things, right? That reflection period is very important. If you keep on jumping from one relationship to the other, you will keep on repeating the pattern. Any advice for my viewers in love? Strength card. So yeah, again, your advice is to just hold on to your inner strength and don't feel like a victim. Why do you feel like a victim? Just because a situation did not happen in your life does not make you a victim, right? I see universe is going to give you an opportunity to basically grow in life. And for that, you just need to be less paranoid and more strong. You are already strong. You need to actually identify your strength. And I also see that this transformation and all of this is going to make you very, very strong. You just need to have your own back, right? So that's what is your advice. Also, don't try to manipulate things. Just because you want things to happen in a certain way, don't try to manipulate your way, because you're already coming out as a cunning person to this person. This person might actually think that, you know, you are manipulative or whatever. Don't try to come out as someone who's manipulative. You are not manipulative is what I see. But just to take control of the situation, you might end up looking like a manipulator. Don't do that. Don't do that freaking mistake, all right? And also, if you want love, if you want somebody to come into your life, set them free. Even when this person appears in your life, don't try to suffocate them, all right? This person, if you and them are meant to be, it's gonna happen. Love does not happen by suffocating each other or trying to check each other's phone to prove their loyalty and all of that. Or you asking this person, like, prove me your loyalty and all of that. Don't do that mistake. All right? Set this person free. If they are meant to be, you guys are going to be together. And I see a very beautiful relationship curating here for you. And 6 months down the line, I see you can actually be in commitment as well. But just make sure that you work on your insecurities and you do not project your insecurities on this person. Alright, give me a message here for my viewer and their person. My family is very judgmental of us being together. That's exactly this Ten of Pentacles. Like, I see family is going to be playing a major role. Either you or this person, we need to become someone who the other person's family can accept. Because I see you are very family oriented, or this person can be very family oriented. So yeah, first, their family needs to agree of you, or maybe your family needs to agree of them. So I see family is going to be a very important part. Some of you, you don't want to go against your family and you want this relationship to happen with consent of family. And that will be a task for you. Like, you will have to agree of family. Because your family could be judgmental, or their family could be judgmental. I will be with you before you realize. But yeah, I see ultimately you guys are going to be together. So you don't have to worry. I feel suffocated sometimes. I can't breathe. That's exactly your advice, that don't try to suffocate this person. If this person comes into your life and things are going well, don't try to ask them to prove their loyalty to you, because you have been cheated in the past. Like, don't try to project your insecurities on someone. Give me a message for my viewer. Getting to know each other and trust. Finance and career. Some of you, as I said, these days you're very focused on finances and career. However, I see there is a potential love coming towards you. You just need to trust that it's gonna happen. Some of you, you have major trust issues because of your trauma, so you need to work on that. And you will be getting to know each other better. So a lot of heart-to-heart conversations are going to happen. So yeah, that was the reading. Hope this helps and resonate. If it does, make sure you subscribe, like, share, comment. I will see you very soon in the next video. You guys take care, stay safe, bye.